Hi guys, my name is Tina Guo and I am a musician and entrepreneur. I've been running my business from home, from my home office slash home music recording studio for the past 10 years. And I wanted to show you guys around a little bit today and also to give you my top 3 tips on how to remain productive when you are working from home. When I come downstairs in the morning, hey guys, this is Bagel, my fur son, and Pizza, my fur daughter. I feed them and let them go to the bathroom outside. I make my coffee, and my studio so it is currently set up as a video recording studio, an audio recording studio, and my office is technically in the living room. We just moved here to this house in Las Vegas a little under 3 weeks ago, though, so things are still being put together. This is my setup. So some of my essential items that I have here in my office is definitely my desk. So these are by Uplift and I absolutely love them. I try to spend time standing and sitting. So this desk goes up and down, which I can adjust. And I try to walk at least 10,000 steps a day while I'm working. And surprisingly, it makes the time go by a lot faster when you're busy, you know, answering emails, doing other logistical things. So I have my walking pad here. It only goes up to 3.5 miles an hour. So there's no chance of me flying off, although I can be clumsy sometimes. So that could happen. I have my cello in the corner. That's my main instrument. I have my keyboard. My headphones are here. I work on an iMac Pro, which I have attached to my TCL TV by HDMI cable, and I just use it as a mirroring screen most of the time or a secondary screen. This is very, very useful when I'm editing audio or video or recording, and what I usually do is I use this keyboard bench. This actually folds in half, which is the reason I got this one in particular, because instead of having to roll it around, it just completely folds in half. I pull out this chair, I sit in front of my microphone setup right here, and I'm able to look up at this screen and read the music or look at the session right off the screen, which is super, super helpful. I have a printer here. This is a wireless printer. Oh, sorry, the kids are playing. I have some of my essential items that I use very often. So some music related things in here. And I have also my speaker, amplifier, and some microphones and musical instruments in this cabinet. But all of my other instruments are actually in a different closet on the other side of the house. At my secondary desk over here on the side, this is where I keep my MIDI keyboard because I don't use it all the time, only when I'm programming or writing. I have some important paperwork that I want to keep really close by over here. I also have some rosin, a hair clip, headphones, a journal. And then this is a great chair. It's actually a kneeling chair, also from Uplift. I actually don't sit very often. For the most part, I'm standing or walking on my treadmill when I'm working, unless I'm recording cello, which I'm sitting on that chair for. But once in a while, I might want to, you know, have a in-between position between actually sitting and standing. So this is a great rocking chair and allows you to kind of sit on your knees. So let me show you what that looks like. And my top 3 tips for staying productive when you are working from home. First one is have a designated workspace. Now, when I first started out, for a while, I was living actually in a garage. So all I had was a futon and a desk and a dresser, but it doesn't really matter as long as you have a designated space, no matter how small or how large. And this also applies if you are traveling and working. So when I work from a hotel room while on tour, I always set up my laptop, whatever equipment I might have with me, you know, my journal, my planner, I have it on my desk, and that is designated as my work area. Number 2 is to schedule out your day. So whether you choose to do a calendar blocking method where you set exact times and time periods, which I sometimes do, today I am not doing that. Today I have a list. You can also just simply write down in your planner or even on a piece of paper, on a napkin, whatever you have, what tasks you need to finish for today. And this is very important to help keep yourself on track, because it is very, very easy to get distracted again when you are working from home, especially in the current situation where maybe all of your family is also around, you know, your pets are running around and you just want to go hang out, watch TV and play with them. So it's very, very important that you have a list to keep yourself accountable. And number three is to try to get moving. So if you find yourself sitting for hours and hours a day, which I did actually right before we moved here a few weeks ago, I had a normal desk that didn't go up and down. So I was sitting for maybe 8 to 9 hours a day on the computer, and I was having a lot of back pain and some different issues with that. So now my new setup allows me actually to stand most of the time when I'm doing my conference calls. Actually, basically when I'm doing everything except for recording cello, which I have to sit down for. Almost everything, I'm always standing, and I try to be walking on the treadmill. And it's amazing how many steps you can get in without even thinking about it if you put it at a reasonably low speed so you don't fly off the treadmill. Thank you guys so much for joining me here at my home office / studio. I hope you stay safe and well, and I wish you a lot of luck and a lot of productivity and relaxation at home.